Lights the lights, lights the lights, lights the lights, lights the lights. How delightful. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Cheese grits is going and it's here hot, ready to go. So my next step is my world famous, yes, world famous strawberry lemonade. First I'm gonna start the syrup. The reason I'm doing the lemonade now is because I want to be nice and cool when my breakfast is done, you know what I'm saying? So anyhow, I got the strawberries in there. This thing I want to do is I want to add and coat my strawberries with the sugar. I'm not really that great at measurements. I just kind of eye these things, but that looks about right. So what I want to do also, after I put the sugar in, is I want to get some water going. So let me get about 2 cups. It's about 2 cups, but I'm not gonna pour it all right now because this is a syrup. This is not meant to dissolve the sugar so much as to make this one thick thing. So, give me a spoon. Come closer, you can see the thickness of the situation. Now after it comes down, you know, breaks down, it's in your lemonade, and it's been frosty for a few days in the bottle. You just, you know, the strawberries, you just wanted to, you know, slip through your mouth. Chew it up, you know, stuff of that nature. So anyhow, so I got that going here, and that's about how you want it to look. You know, it's not too thick, not too light, and we just wait for that to boil. Well, actually, what we want to do next is we're going to add some vanilla, excuse me. All right, so some vanilla extract. This is kind of the secret ingredient here, because vanilla does this thing with bringing out flavor. It brings out the flavor of the fruit or whatever you're making. Like, it's just a great additive. And you want this to taste like strawberries because it's strawberry lemonade, and that just makes sense. So I still don't need to wait before I put this in now. This is my first time, you know, using this lemon juice, but we're gonna, because usually I just go get the, you know, real big bottle, the cheap one, and I'll just keep measuring it out. But this is all the lemon juice I have, and this is all the lime juice I have. And I thought about lime just to make it, you know, make it a little bit interesting, a little lemon limeade, strawberry lemon limeade. But we'll see if we need that much. But I'm gonna go ahead and just be done with this bottle here. What is it? 4 ounces of lemon juice. Oh, maybe I don't need to. Okay, we're gonna test it out and see what happens, but about that much of the bottle left. I don't know if that's half, but about half left. And come close now, what you're gonna see here is as it's boiling up, you see that the sugar and the mixture itself is turning pink. That's right, because the strawberry's color is gonna wash out into the syrup. This is gonna be a red syrup after this. So it's going good so far. While that's happening, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna turn on the oil to my fish. I should have did that a while ago, but oh well. Constantly stirring it. We don't want it to, you know, to stick to the bottom or anything like that. How many strawberries? Give or take, what would you say, 12, Faye?
A little bit more than that.
Okay. Yeah, I'll listen.
Closer to 20.
My camerawoman, Phaedra Hyde.
What's up? What's up?
Doing this thing, you know, trying to make big moves. Big moves. So look at that. Oh. Faye, talk about how it smells, girl. Does it smell all right to you?
It smells like summertime.
That's what's up.
Smells like summer.
So I'm going to lessen the heat a little bit, give it a little bit more time. I do want to taste it, but it's too hot to do that right now.
Don't do that. Do not.
Get my mouth off.
No, yeah, don't do that.
So, fish oil is getting ready. Yes, the fish oil. Water on standby just in case I need it. The grits, I decided I'm going to add more cheese because they said they wanted cheese grits. So we might as well make it cheesy. I did put more cheddar than mozzarella because mozzarella is not the traditional cheese that you usually even use in the grits. But like I said, you can cook grits however you like. So you pay attention in your kitchen. See, that's the ninja move right there. It try to overflow on me. I can't have that. That means it's just about ready. I'm going to take it off the heat, put it to the side, go back to these grits. You cook your grits to the consistency you like it. I don't like it too grainy. I like it smooth, you know. I like it. I like to put hot sauce in things. People make it sweeter. Whatever. This is cheese grits though. And you gotta make sure you stir in the grits right. Whatever seasonings you're using, it's best to go ahead and put all your seasonings in the water that's boiling. And I put a quarter stick of butter in the water before I added the grits. This way all the flavor goes to every grit in the pot. I'm keeping it on low so that it stays nice and silky for me till I'm ready to eat it up. But the grits is done, like I said. Here's the strawberry syrup. Now, I want to taste it. This has to be almost like I can't take it sweet because you're adding it to a lot of water in order to make it happen. So I'll put that there. Not quite. That's right, dangerously sweet. And dangerously lemony. So we're gonna put a little bit more sugar. And we don't forget that this is lemonade, so we do want it to taste lemony. I'm gonna go ahead and add all this bottle, that's right. I think I'm gonna get funky with it and with a twist of lime. Okay. Of course, I want to check it again before I do the final step. You smell that now? Does it smell a little bit more potent than before?
Yes, definitely.
You smell the lemon?
Mm-hmm.
Usually when I use it, I might get a real lemon too and cook it in there because the skin from the lemon, the rind, is going to give it so much more attitude. You know what I mean? That's gonna give it more zesty, lemony zestiness. That's right, you could look that up, lemony zestiness. All right, so anyhow. Oh, that oil is ready. Attacking me, as you can see. I don't know everything about the kitchen. I ain't going to test for that. I just like to cook. So you might see some things go down here. Okay, understand.
Uncut. So,
how many minutes in are we, Faye?
About 8 minutes, 30 seconds.
That's what you... See the face? The face is supposed to be. You just can't take it no more. But I don't think we have enough lemon. So I am going to put my twist of lime in there. Because like I said, it's very important. So just a quick little squeeze of that.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, man. This is doing it crazy here for y'all. Mm-hmm. Ladies,
doing
and
it.
Healing it up. So, I mean, nothing's final till the final, but I like to put all the sugar there, whatever. So now, I'm pretty much done with that. Piece of cake. Strawberry lemonade syrup. Now, I want it, come this way, I want it for my brunch. So I got wise, and I froze my water. Half of it at least. So it'll be nice and at least close to cold because this is extremely hot, this is extremely cold, so it's whatever happens. But now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my syrup and pour it right on top. And it goes in, see how it melts everything down. I'm going to do about half of it because I want to make sure that this is what I want it to be. Now, I got my lime juice on standby just in case I want to make it even more zesty. Because it's just something about having it like that. You know what? I'm going to put some. Well, a little bit more than half of what I made. But you can eye it and gauge it. You know, it's just like everything else. You decide how sweet you want that Kool-Aid, you know? So, I'm going to go ahead and test it out. Now, you might want to put something else in your mouth. No pun intended. But you might want to put something else in your mouth because you just had it extremely sweet. So, you might not be able to taste it, you know, at the right whatever. But I did a trick. Y'all didn't see what I did. And I'm not going to tell you because it's my trick. Secret. But now I'm going to taste it. Oh, it's really sweet. So now, I'm gonna add a little bit more lime to mine and add a little bit more water to alleviate the sweetness, but it's pretty much done. There it is, strawberry lemonade back in the freezer because we want it frosty. Ain't nothing like no hot lemonade. Oh yeah, strawberry lemon limeade. That's what we made just now, right? So anyhow, that's in there. So, like I said, we use what we got. And using what we got, I'm thinking breakfast, dinner, I like vegetables with my dinner. Like, it has to be a vegetable with my dinner plate. But this is breakfast, and I thought instead of vegetables, we could do fruits. So we had a couple of nectarines, we chopped that up real small, and with the strawberries left over from the strawberry, the extra strawberries I had. Anyway, so I have that. I want to make a quick fruit salad to kind of, you know, top off our meal. So what I got here is I got some granola, a little bit of raisins. I'm gonna go ahead, this is whole grain granola, just a couple of handfuls of it. Put that in there. Now I can't do nothing regular, right? So I need to make some kind of a dressing. This is a salad, right? So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna get some honey. Can't go wrong with honey. Get it in there. So anyway, that's the honey. Then I'm gonna go ahead and use the apple cider vinegar. Just a little bit of that because it's really strong, but to help distribute the honey and the granola and to make it more of a dressing. So just a couple dashes of that. And back to some vanilla. Just for attitude. Then I'm gonna go ahead and give me a little fork here. Come closer and I'll show you. Stirring it up. This simple. Oh, I did forget one little thing. I don't know, I like the bite. The lovely, lovely, lovely bite of ginger. I got a little ground ginger here. The freshier ingredients, the better though. So if there was some chopped ginger, you know how bad this salad would be right now. But hey, we working with what we got. And it's gonna be good either way. That's how we do things. So ginger, granola, honey, little vanilla. That's our salad. And because it's salad, I'm gonna go ahead and put that in the refrigerator. Just like
the
that.
The fish. Come closer, sis.
So I marinated the fish and put it in the fridge for about a half an hour. I don't believe in cooking anything like fish or meat or chicken, poultry, without marinating it first. It doesn't make any sense to do it otherwise. So what I'm doing now, which I should have did earlier while I was marinating, was proposing it so it could go through the meat. But we straight, it's been in there. It's fish, it's tilapia, it's what I got going on here. Now, some people use whiting, catfish, whatever fish is your fish of choice.